shelter will have to do until the storm's over. Better take your wet things off. Make yourselves as comfortable as possible.
Who's there?
I'm sorry if I startled you. We were lost in the storm, and I hardly expected to find a place like this.
Welcome. Welcome to the hospitality afforded by the home of an ancient people.
Thanks. Say, do you mean that at some time a primitive people made this cave their home?
Of that I'm quite sure.
Well, what in the world leads you to believe that?
These markings. Hidden for many centuries, which I've been able to uncover.
Am I to understand that there's a meaning to these marks that you can decipher?
Not only a meaning, but a complete story as well. On this wall, a learned man left a saga.
That's amazing.
Yes.
My friends and I are most interested in things of this kind. May I have your permission to bring them in so they can see this unusual place?
Well, by all means, invite them in. And while they're waiting for the storm to pass to entertain them, I'll be glad to give my interpretation of the simple story that's left here.
Oh, thanks. This will make losing our way really worthwhile.
These strange figures and forms were carved here many years ago. Or any record of our present civilization.
They speak the message of an intelligent man.
Do you mean there were people of intelligence that long ago?
Intelligence, my friend, is inherent. Education and culture are acquired. Civilization, of course, has brought complications. But here are the same thoughts, the same emotions, the same struggles with the problems of life and death that we of today experience.
I've always thought of those ancient people as animals rather than humans. In order that we can have a better understanding of this story, will you first give us some idea of what they looked like?
I don't know. I never thought of it. Never seemed important to me what they looked like. Suppose we assume that they were just human beings like you people sitting here. The story concerns a young hunter of one tribe and a young girl of another. Maybe the girl resembled this young lady. The boy might have looked like this young man sitting here. Perhaps he was just the same age. The saga concerns two tribes. To avoid confusion, suppose we say the boy belonged to the rock people and the girl the shell people. Our story opens with the rock tribe. The young hunter we'll call Tumac. His was a cruel tribe. Pity and compassion played little part in the existence of those people, who ate only what they could kill. They depended solely upon their ability to kill for sustenance. They despised weakness, worshipped strength. They ruled by the power of might. The strongest was their leader. Well, we first find them over here in search of food. Animals were abundant. None of them had learned to fear man, which made the hunter's life most hazardous.
These people lived in the highlands, a country denied natural beauty by lava rock and glacial flow. Their home was a cave on the crags, hollowed by the convulsions of a young earth. Here in the bleak mountains, the mighty mastodon roamed at will. The saber-toothed tiger stalked giant deer, and the vulture forever followed the shadow of the hated hyena. Here, life lived hand in hand with death. And compensation came only to the strong. They hunted as primitively as they lived, knowing no weapons except a crude staff, which responded only to brute strength. Akoba, their leader, was the mightiest hunter of them all. Tumak, son of Akoba, begged for the right to his first kill.
Thank you. Thank you. Connor. Yatan. Yatan.
Tumac. on, go on up.
Bonito, Tumac. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Fire China!
Picasso?
Picasso? Picasso?
Thank you.
shore.
Luana. Mata Tumac. Luana. Andy.
Wendy! The party!
Thank you. Come on.